Afterwards, and there we go. Hi everyone, Tim here. So this is yet another live stream in building products with JavaScript series. And last time we've built the authentication part, so this time we can actually get to the writing the logic, right? So here we have there's been a few actually pull requests by the viewers who helped quite a lot. Let's have a look at the commits. Actually, the one of them I have already merged, which is the fix for user data. So I did a very dumb thing and I try to store the and retrieve the action payload as which is an object into the local storage. And you know, if you know how local storage works, it stores only strings. So obviously that would store an object string, which you know is not really helpful. So thank you. What was the name of the person here? Javier. Thank you, Javier, for this pull request. That is really helpful. I mean, at some point we would have caught that, but it's always better to sort of, you know, have it from the beginning. So thank you for catching that, and thank you for fixing it for me. There is another pull request that I'm waiting for some small changes here, which fixes the issue with notification system. Once again, here is an issue. So the thing is basically errors are not reset once you change between login and register pages because they use the same error code, which which is a bit annoying. So yeah, we're working on that. Okay, so let's start by doing one thing. So I found this Redux history transition thing, which is actually recommended to use for transitions. We are gonna yarn out that thing, that annoying bug with hyperterminal, which doesn't allow you to paste unless you click on it, is infuriating me sometimes. Okay, so what do we need? Create an enhanced store. Okay, let's see, we need a store. Where is our store? Our store is over here, right? And we need to import handle transitions. Okay, there are some ESLint issues with the old Airbnb config. All right, okay, we need to enhance history actually, And we fit in create store reducer enhancer, But yeah, okay, here is my browser history, okay. So we enhancer, which means we will call that transition middleware. I mean, enhancer is not a very good word. Handle transitions, browser history, that should do it. And apply middleware transition. So theoretically, that should, wait. So reducer initial state, that the question is it compatible actually with the latest version? A year, 7 months ago, it might as well not be, but let's give it a shot. Why not? All right, so we did that, and then once we want to transition, you just need to provide this metadata here. That means we go into our epics, right? And in the login success, for example, we say we have a metadata which should add this transition function. I guess, yeah, it is a function. So previous state, next state, action, yeah, I don't care about that, so we just redirect to home. We don't care about state, so let's just try the stupidest thing. That means we don't need that part. Right, that looks fine. What is wrong with my ESLint? Is it because of that Ali thing? Wait a second, where's my ESLint RC? I think I fixed that already. Yeah, there we go. This is what I did. So we are gonna do exactly the same here. And I guess I need to restart the code because otherwise I won't reload the ESLint config, which is slightly annoying. I'm actually trying to switch from Atom to Visual Studio Code because the why you don't like, come on, I just overridden it, has content. Yes, this is the one that I have here, so what the hell. Configuration for rule. Okay, is it because of this? Wait a second. Reload window. Come on. Did that? Nope, that is still. Ah, come on. Right. Slightly annoying. I thought that should fix it. Airbnb, yes, Lynn, yes. Here I have my anchor has content thing. Okay, let's try. Maybe I am missing something. It would be not very good, but let's see. Configuration rule is invalid. Yeah, there we go. This is my problem. Only supports. Ah, okay. So it wants version 2. Minus G install. Come on, paste it. 2. All right, npm d minus gls. Let me see if I have 2 of them now installed. That would not be very good. Okay, so it's installed version 2, which theoretically I don't need that anymore. It's kind of annoying that once you do default installs, you kind of get these errors anyway. Oh, okay, come on, let's reload the whole thing. Come on. And no errors now, right? So we seem to be working finally. Yeah, there we go. Okay, cool. So we need that part. And if I go login and I don't need that. So I just gonna console log here. We are logged in. So just so that we know that we're actually logged in. And let me fire up my development browser over here. Not on that screen, thank you very much. Okay, so what do we actually need? Let me fire up another terminal, which I don't need you to be that big. So, building products, yes, server. So, wait a second. I have some old stuff in there, so let me kill all of that stuff and remove all of that stuff. Come on, exit it right. Okay, so now I should have a clean Docker, and now I can do npm run db, what was it, create, right? Oh god, I wiped a Docker recently because of some problems we had. Or rather, I had with my local installation, so I had to wipe it and re-pull half of the images, which can be annoying. It doesn't actually look correct in this terminal, but okay. Docker ps minus a, we got the thing to be running, which is good. So again, just do npm start right now, and we should get our backend working. Yes, I've updated node as well. Cool. So we got that running. Now we can do npm start over here in the client. We should get our localhost 3000. Let me fire up the inspector right away. And okay, now it's valid. What? Unexpected token O at position 1. What? Wait, what? All right. Did I, okay, screw up somewhere here? Response, meta, path name. First of all, we can, no, I guess arrow function would be better here. Okay, it shows an error. So what's an error? Did I put one too many? So I added this meta, right? So if I remove that, what's the error here actually? It's just missing trailing comma. Okay. That's not a big deal. So what the hell is it? Reducer, yes, okay. Store index 6. That undefined. Why is it undefined? What's going on? Is that thing? It is that why? Why? Okay, you know what? I am not gonna dig through that right now because that's probably gonna take some time tracking all those issues. So what I'm gonna do now is, I don't even care about that. Let me just close this and I'm just gonna reset. Wait, let me have a look at the div. So you check out head, let's just reset this whole thing. All right, cool. So I just reset everything. This is something I think I gotta dig alone on my own, basically, and once it works, I'll just show you what's been done. So let's go with whatever we have right now. Let's npm start this thing and make sure it actually works. Come on, okay, bundle is finished, there we go. Is it? No, okay, so what the hell is going on here? It worked last time. What is it now? Webpack, Bootstrap, Store Reducers, and Oath, Hello World, yes. Why is it suddenly broken? Is it the Node 7 thing or something? Okay, you know what? Let me do the thing that always helps. This. Maybe I run npm or yarn upgrade? I think I did. Maybe that broke it. So that's upgrade procedures are always a bit wonky with Node.js, so it's always a good idea to wipe your node modules and reinstall everything if something goes south. Come on. There we go. npm start. Let's see. Do we get this error now or are you fixed yet? No, we still get that. This is the most obscure error I've seen ever. Okay, store reducers index. Yes, we got one from Hello World and we got one from Oath. Okay, so what the hell? So you got, oh, I know what's the problem. Yeah, okay. That is, even though the pull request was fine, but obviously this won't work, right? Because if we try to execute that right now in the console, we will get an unexpected token in JSON position. Yeah, of course. So what you actually want to do is you want to const stored user. So we have to first load that. And basically then if stored user is something, we will have to JSON parse it, right? Otherwise it's gonna be undefined. So I think now that should work. Let's recompile. I expect a token, wait, what? Is it not null? What is going on? Let me see the user. Yeah, okay. That's my old data that is actually broken. 10 10 10, I'm thinking, yeah, okay, you know what, const user, I am gonna do it in this way. I am gonna say that there is a let user which is undefined. Now I'm gonna do a try, basically assign with try JSON parse. So let's do it properly. Store user catch error, and then let's just do console error parsing user data, right? Okay, and then here we can just say user, and in this case, what you don't like, unnecessary need, yeah, I mean that makes sense, parse user from stored string. There we go. So there we go. Okay, so basically, because I still have the old token, which actually will, I'll get the Ethereum. So let's wipe the whole storage thing and reload. So we should get to the login. We need to register again. Test 1 of 3. User already, right, I had the database saved. Cool, so we can, what was the test? Yeah, there we go. Okay, nice. Finally works. Cool. So we got stats. Let's commit that. Git status. So let's make sure that, yeah, git sm. How do we call this commit? We will call it fix user. Come on. Fix loading user from local store storage. Correctly try to catch JSON parse errors. Okay, good. Now, I think I actually need, let me open it in Sublime, I guess, server test code, because that would make sense, right? So we need, first we need to get, or I mean, I'm thinking, so we need basically to get questions, and we need to create questions, and we need to list questions. Okay, this is all post a p question main. What do we have in main? No, this is not it. Let me see. Am I an idiot and forgot to? Yeah, I forgot to create a method that actually lists all questions, which is kind of ridiculous. But hey, we can fix that quite easily. All right, so I guess we are gonna go with fixing the server right now. So let's do that. As you can see, you know, I'm if you don't have a proper spec, you will always miss some of those things that you actually have to do. So it's inevitable that you will go back and will change the old code. So I'm just gonna copy this part and p questions. I'm gonna get questions. No, let's just leave it like this, and it's gonna be question. Right, question. I already forgot the rethinkDB syntax. RethinkDB, yes. I hope the website is still alive. Okay, that is good. Docs. Quick start, that's all I need. I think there should be starting regular language. 10 minute guide. No, I think API should be fine. So we just need to filter and maybe limit. Basically filter. Wait a second. So get connect, use, blah blah blah. What was the limit thing? Yeah, that's I guess we just take example from here. Order by and then limit. Yeah, that should be sufficient, I think. So you can do that. And order by in our case would be date. What is our date thing? Creation date. So this is what we're interested in, and then we're gonna limit it to 10. I mean, we can add pagination later. Get later 10 latest questions. Okay, and it might be a good idea to actually add a unit test for that right away. Let me think. So we got questions. Should not create question, should not create question, should create new question, create new. So we got two questions, and then we can copy that test and make sure that there are actually two questions created. Question, get all 10 latest, get, let's call it get latest questions. So we remove that part, and we actually don't need the template here. So we got a token, we got the body, we got, okay, so we should have this one, which should be the first one, and this one, which should be the second one, right? No, question is maybe valid. Okay, so we got shared input. Okay, so we got shared input here. Okay, so actual body is an array, and then we got check, I guess t equal actual body length 2, retrieve, retrieve 2 questions. And then we take the first one, and then after that we should use this one, right? So this is gonna be 0. Yeah, let's just split it by 2. Should be 1. So okay, we did that. Okay, this is also 0. like this, right? So let's run npm test and see if that actually works. Nope, that fails. What do we get here? So I guess it has to be, this one has to be 1. And this one has to be, yeah, okay, right. It's gonna be the other way around, right? That's a bad idea. So they should be sorted by, wait a second, order by, yeah, I want to order by in reverse, right? Because we want to care about the newest ones first. What was it? Order by date, order by index, order by, there we go. That's what I want, right? So I want our descending creation date, and this R is it exported in DB? That's the question. Index R, yes. So I can just say R question, and in theory that should work. Come on. Still some errors. Belongs to correct user, and so they are still swapped. Why are they still swapped? It doesn't make, okay, which one we create actually first? So oh yeah, that's right, because this one is created first, this one is created second, so if we sorted descending they should be a swap. Okay, that actually makes sense. So this is what I am gonna do it. No. And cut all of that, and then it should work. So okay, me screwing up the logics. It's you know, it's Saturday evening, and it's not that easy to think. So at least for me now, I'm feeling sleepy as hell actually today. But you know, right? Okay, now what do you don't like now? Where are the errors? There we go. 2 question actual 10. I guess it doesn't wipe database there. Okay, so retrieve 10 latest. I mean, that won't work, right? Because it should. Wait, don't I wipe the database first? Oh, I only wipe the user. Question, right? So this is what I'm interested in. And let's test it. So now we should only have this, yes, okay. Prior okay, true, actual, false. Retrieve same question expression date. So what do you don't like here? Oh, okay, and it should be shared input other, and now it should pass. There we go, good. So, whoops, just to make sure that everything is correct. Cool. Add method to fetch 10 latest, or let's just say latest questions. Cool. I'm not going to push that just yet. Let's go to clients. Right. So we can actually npm start our server. Okay, perfect. Everything works. Right, so I can actually close, no, I don't want to close that, right? So we want to start writing our reducers and epics and actions as well, actually. So first, let's create an action, get all questions. We don't need any payload here right now, so let me just say type action types. We're gonna go to action types and questions actions, let's call it this way. I'm gonna say export const get all questions. right? And I'm just gonna copy that thing over here. Cool, and so we're gonna say get all questions. This is why I like the Visual Studio Code, by the way. The auto completion is amazing in comparison to pretty much everything else. It works so well. Like I tried using TurnJS for Atom and it works decently until it crashes. But this is just like way, way, way better. And with the introduction of the IntelliSense, like smart IntelliSense that automatically downloads typings when they are present for the packages in 172, it gets even better for the third-party packages. Okay, we got actions. So let's start with the reducer again, I guess. Let me think. So we need what? We need questions, right? Let's call it questions.js. Gonna just copy this hello world reducer here, initial state. We're gonna say questions empty. So we're gonna have an empty array of questions now. And export con questions, right? So, questions and then status inited. So let's do it this way. And then if we get all questions, we set status. So, and then questions to, so we reset it. Basically, we say the questions are again empty and we are loading. And this is not something we need right now. Let me clean that. Okay, so I'm just gonna command that for now. Okay, now we need to export it from here. Export questions from questions. There we go. And I'm gonna put it over here. So we did reducer, we have our action, and now we need actually epic, right? Okay, so we're gonna do questions.js here as well. Gonna again take the hello world one. No, I don't think I need, I actually wanna take the authentication one, right? Because we're gonna do requests and we already have requests ready here. So let's questions action. Of type, I guess this is gonna be get questions, get all questions. Yeah, I mean, let's call it get all questions, why the hell not? So we're waiting for get all questions, then we are sending the request to API questions. But the thing is that we actually need to sign the request, right? So we actually need this token that we get during the authentication that should be in the headers. RxJS, let me have a look at the Ajax function. So I don't really care about all of that stuff yet. We're gonna have a look at that later. Let's see, .ajax, ajax.post, I think it was, right? Yeah, and we need describe post expected, yeah, that's not what I want. Headers, there we go. So we got string body headers, and then in this case, what I am gonna do here is I'm gonna map that sign request, right? And then it's gonna be headers here, and we're gonna say headers here. So we're gonna create this sign request right now, which should be imported from. It's a good question where to put that. I guess into the utilities, right? New file, sign request. Okay, so export const sign request. So this is the request. Yeah, let's just call it request. And what we actually wanna do is very simple. We wanna expand request here. And in our case, we are, I mean, one of the ways would be to, where's my reducer, authentication reducer. So in this case, we are, since we're storing the data before actually putting it in the store, we can just use this get item user token, right? To, where's my sign request thing? To say that headers, this is our token, and I think we should be x header x access token, right? This is what we should set. So x access token, And that's basically our sign request function. You are not happy about my brackets here, right? Yeah, there we go. Okay, I need to export it actually. Export sign request from sign request. There you go. And import sign request from util. That's two levels, right? Util. There we go. So theoretically, that should send. Okay, we need what? Get all questions. I guess. Yeah, I mean, get all questions, then received. I always mistype received actually for whatever reason. I kind of mess up the. Yeah, okay. EI, not the other way around. Received all questions. Okay, so we're gonna add another one, and once it's done, okay, and we need an error constant as well. So error getting all questions, let's call it this way. They are getting really long, and that starts to remind me about Java, which is not something I like to be reminded of. Okay, I mean, maybe we should actually just follow the old schema, get all questions success. That makes more sense. Get all questions error. Let me change that here. Yeah, that looks more sane. Okay. Get all questions success and get all questions error. Right, you want a comma here, right? Yeah, okay, cool. So that we have that, yeah, okay, we need to import get all questions from questions, right? And then questions here and get all questions. Okay, there we go. Got action types, we got our reducer, we got epic, we got actions. So basically once we enter home, we actually should trigger that loading. So I don't want to do the stateful component, but on the first, so basically what it should do, it should be triggered right before that, right? Which means in a successful login. So nav to home, and our nav to home here is this dispatch push. So basically in addition to this dispatch, we want to say that we want to do what? We want to call the action, right? So I want to dispatch, and I want to dispatch our get all questions. There we go. And get all questions should be imported from actions. Right, so theoretically, the only problem is that basically once you enter the page, it won't be loaded, which is, I guess we don't want to do that, right? Because then if you already authenticated and have the token, you will go to the home page and you won't see anything, which is suboptimal. Okay, yeah, sure, why not? Let's trigger the loading in the home page, right? So basically, let me think, would it be a good idea? I mean, we can basically just say, hey, we don't care about that for now. Let's close all of that. So we need this part and let's leave home all for this here for now. So we need fetch questions, right? And this is gonna be dispatch get all questions action, and basically fetch questions. So but yeah, that is probably gonna be internal server error, so it doesn't like something. The query did not return. Yeah, okay. So this is expectable. Actually, we should have written a unit test for that as well. Server, let's do that now. I still have it open, right? Good. Okay. Okay, now we have a lot of changes. Wait a second, did I just get shown? No, I did everything correct. Okay, so we need what? We need to, why is it still marked as question? So before we actually retrieve that part, before we create new questions, should not create. So there's two methods that try to create questions, but they should fail. Should get empty latest questions. It's actually questions here, right? Yeah. Okay, so we don't need all of that stuff here, but should retrieve zero questions, and there should be an empty array, and there should not be any error here. Which means that in this case, what I need to do here is I need to wrap it into try catch. Let's comment that out for a second and do npm test here. So there is like where we want to catch one very specific, ESLint. Want to catch one very specific error, right? Because if we catch all of them, there might be some errors that we actually want to show as errors. Hey? Wait, now you work? What? This is login, this is user, this is question, get latest questions, get empty. Okay, now it gets empty question. So why the hell does it throws me an error over here? Query did not... table user get okay because the yeah right I reset the database, so that actually works just fine. That well, we added the test here, so that's a good thing. Let's the error was not there. Git commit and test to check the return of zero questions. Let's do that, and we go to client. I think we just need to re-log in basically, right? Because the there you go. So I need a node. Wait, npm start. Need our server, and if I log in now, no. So it wiped the database. Is that the thing? Yes. Okay. Test. Right. And bad request. Okay. Text should be present. What text? What are you talking about now? Wait. What is going on? This is options. Post. Why is it post? Did I screw it up and then it did a post there? Let me think. Epics questions. Yes, I did. Okay, get. And we don't actually need the payload here, right? So we only want headers because this is a get request. Right, okay. And let's see, network question preview. Ah, there is actually already a test question. Cool. So what we need now is we need to render that, right? So I think we assign this to, let me have a look. So get all questions success, and we want to see the payload. Yeah, so the payload, and let's adjust this and say that the questions is, we can alias that, right? So we can just do this. Questions, okay. Let me think. We need here, we need to say case. What's wrong with my intendation? Come on, okay. Actions get all questions success. say questions, payload questions, and status done, right? And we need to handle an error, types error, return, so what do we need to return here? Let's have a look at the authentication. We need to return some error basically, and I guess we can expand the old state and status error, and error is gonna be whatever I used, action payload error. Yeah, that sounds about right. Am I setting the error here correctly? Yeah, I said, okay, cool. And we might alias that as well, because why the hell not? Nobody likes more lines of code than it's required to set, right? Cool, okay, so now we have that part, and now we need to actually edit our homepage to render that stuff. I still don't like that, so I will have to dig around to see, you know, what's sort of the best way to actually trigger that, because we want to trigger that on a page ender, but we want to only trigger that once, not on every navigation. Maybe it's a good idea actually to trigger it on every navigation, but let's see how it works out. All right, so we got that part. We need to render our questions here, right? So what I'm thinking is I'm gonna kill that jumbotron there. Let's go to get bootstrap and let's make this page look nice. There should be a navigation bar component. There we go. So let's start copy pasting things. Okay, I actually want a div that gonna wrap all of that stuff. So I'm gonna leave this jumbotron here for now, which will have our old code. Okay, class name, there we go. Nav, Okay, do I want to make it fluid or not? Yeah, I mean, why not? Let's do it this way. So we have fluid container slash div. Why is it empty containers? Yeah, okay. Nav bar header. Do we need a brand one? I mean, sure, why not? Let's make it a branded thing. So I don't think I need that button yet, at least. We're gonna keep it simple here for now. Nav bar brand, href, let's make it, okay, we're not gonna make it this, we're gonna make it a link to a slash link, and then class name is gonna be brand. Okay, I think that should render our, cool, and yeah, okay, that works. Now we need some buttons. So we don't need collapse because I didn't use the, I removed the buttons there basically, so we're not gonna use it. Slash ul class name, and in this case we want two links. So let's say class name, I actually want, okay, let's, I guess we can just create one first and then copy it to show whatever we want. Link to slash, that will be duplicating, but whatever. Let's call it browse questions, right? Right, we have to close the link. There we go. Cool, so now we have these browse questions, and we need another one which will say create new question. And we are gonna be creating that page momentarily, right? So yeah, okay, now it's gonna be 404, which makes sense. Okay, so this will add our navbar, which should be good. So, and now we need to actually add list of questions, right? So how does, I already forgot actually how our question object looks. Okay, we got creation date, we got owner, we got text. It might be a good idea to pre-fill owner, but let's not care about that for now. So all the pretty things can be done later on. Let me think. Pages maybe in CSS. I think there was a nice element that we could just use to render that stuff. And sort of maybe is a table. No, table sounds like a bad idea. Right, let's take a look. Breadcrumbs, pagination, labels, badges, page headers, thumbnails, alerts, panels maybe? Yeah, panels look nice. Let's do it this way. So we got, let's create folder, no, don't collapse it. Components. So we're gonna introduce a new concept which will be called components. It's going to be a question component, and it's going to have index.js in here, which will be, okay, we need a React here and export a default function that gets, this is going to be props, right? And I'm going to return that. Okay, we need to say class name here, panel about hitting. Okay, so we got that part, trading white spaces. Okay, let me do this npm packages, and this is gonna be our packages. Import question from components. Question, there we go. And what I'm gonna do next, I'm gonna kill this Jumbotron here because we don't really care about it anymore, right? And I'm gonna do, oh, we actually have to map here, yeah. So I can kill this hello world stuff because we don't care about it anymore. And this on click as well, there we go. And yeah, okay, I already have question state, questions. Which is a bit too nested. Maybe we'll have to rework that or refactor that a bit later on, but let's see. So questions. And just to make sure it works, let's do it this way, stringify questions, right? So we theoretically, we should see after I refresh that. Okay, so we'll just keep requesting it all the time on re-renders with new questions. No, oh God, that is that, no, stop. Yeah, I know it cannot be said, oh, come on, yeah. That's why I was saying that is probably a bad idea. Let me see, that is a lot of things that I don't, developer tools, express client, please die. There we go. Okay. I mean, I guess the stupidest option to do it would be import from Lodash. Do I have Lodash as, actually don't have Lodash. This is surprising. Like Lodash is one of those, yeah, come on. Lodash is one of those libraries that I use just about in any projects that I have and I work with, basically, because it has so many features that can save you time that it's just very hard not to use it, basically. Okay, and in this case we wanna do this, I mean, that would be the stupidest thing, but basically, let's see, I think it was like Lodash once. Why you? Yeah, come on. Yeah, okay, that one, no, okay. Is it still requesting that stuff again and again? Yes, it does. Maximum call stack exceeded, okay. What was the hotkey? No, it's wrong button. Come back. Task manager. CPU. Okay, well, at least it doesn't load anything anymore. So we are just gonna use once, I think. Yes, there we go. And I'm gonna say that I am just gonna do this, right? So theoretically that should be only executed once, The only problem is that obviously if we navigate somewhere else and then come back, I know it still is, okay, right, because it is recreated every time. Yeah, okay, cool. So that works perfectly fine for now. We don't get a bunch of stack traces and stack overflows, basically, questions. And now, if I refresh that, we should see JSON for questions. Perfect. So what I am gonna do now is I'm gonna say questions map question, and we're gonna map them to question, and then I'm just gonna say question question. We're gonna use question 25 more times, just for the sake of it. Okay, kill that, and we're gonna have a nice one-liner here. Okay, cool. So we now have, yeah, that's a valid point. Question ID, I think it has, right? Let's quickly check. So you need, if you render an array of things, you need to give them unique keys, otherwise they will, the React will not know how to utilize and reuse them correctly. So that's why I gave it key question ID. And you know, that's we're basically done with the main page, so we only need to tweak this component now, which is a great thing about React question. So what I'm gonna do here is I'm gonna say this is gonna be question, let's see, in our data structure, no, come on, question text. So this is gonna be our text, and if I refresh it, I should see the text now. Yes, so we have it. And what we need to do is we need to write answers, right? So in this case, we need to show answers, and we need a field for answering. Answers, there we go. And let me think, was there a panel footer? Yeah, there we go. So we're gonna use the footer to add our own input field, basically, right? Okay, there's gonna be, let's just, you know what, let's just, I'm a lazy person, so let's go ahead and go to the CSS here and copy our nice formatted input from over here, forms. There we go, inline form, and that's what I want. I don't think I need the whole thing. So we can actually, no, it's, we need a form tag anyway, because accessibility is always important. So I think we would need only button and one input, right? So let's first select all this class stuff and convert it to class name. Form, yes, okay. Sure, only answer input. Let's rename that part. Placeholder, enter your answer, right? Your answer, that's what we want to show here. Type text, submit answer, and we need to close the input tag because and this is, should be HTML4, right? So if I refresh that, we should see a thing here. Yeah, and maybe it's a good idea to, I don't remember if there was actually the tag that would call us M10. Yeah, maybe we can just do call us M10. Would that be sufficient? It doesn't stretches it, which is kind of annoying. Call us M12. Would that work? No, it won't. Form input. Okay, maybe, you know what, maybe we don't need that stuff. Maybe we just, we don't need group, we just say that. And in this case, it still doesn't scale. Form horizontal, maybe that's why that worked. Yeah, there we go, cool. So now we have that. And in case of answers, we need what? We need to say, basically, question answers length, right? And if it's greater than zero, then we render answers, and if not, there's no answers yet. Let's just render spawn here for now. Cool, and now we actually need to write the way to answer stuff. So if I do that now, obviously nothing happens. And we need to provide on answer here. So, right, okay. We need to use references again, right? Because we need to know the value of let answer input. And then we're gonna say here that ref. I guess it's gonna be better to split it into multi-line thing because we're gonna have a pretty lengthy ref here. You go back here and then ref. Should be I, and then it should be answer input equals I, right? I think you want, no, you don't, you want this, right? You want to have this kind of formatting to not be, and then you want, okay, you want that, okay. No ESLint problems. What do you highlight input trailing spaces? Okay, there we go. Cool. We got input, we got it marked, and now once we do, let me do it this way as well, on click here, I am gonna say, okay, so we click that stuff. I think it's gonna handle click. And then the const handle click. It's gonna be basically on answer from answer input and value. This is what we're gonna do. So basically now I need to go to the home page and provide this question. Let me do it this way. But that's a bit too much. There you go. On click. No, wait. On answer, right? Yeah. You need to provide it on answer, which we're gonna say handle answer, and it's gonna be a value. And for now, let's just make sure that actually works. Answer value. And another point, we also need to say, yeah, that should be event, and we need to say prevent default, right? Because otherwise it will submit the form and refresh the page, which is I forgot to assign it here, and handle answer. Yeah, there we go. And now if I enter something, it still, why do you submit the form? I don't want you to submit the form. Am I sure it is correct? Yeah, okay, so why the hell does that happen? I just prevented the default event, right? Do I need to stop immediate propagation? Is that the thing as well? Yeah, there we go, cool. No, not cool. Oh God, what was the name of that thing? Event stop immediate propagation, yeah, so prevent form submit. I think you're just preventing default should be, or you return false, is that the thing? Return false. Is that what you want? Yeah, there we go, cool. All right, so we now have that. I think this part is basically done. Okay, we have to also render answers. But before we render them, we actually have to create answers. So we are gonna get, go here and say answer question. It's gonna be an answer. Get all questions. So it's gonna be, let's do question, and then we're gonna do answer question. There we go. Okay, and it's gonna be answer. Nope, come on, answer question, and then answer, right? So payloads. I mean, like with the same success, I can just call it payload here as well, because why the hell not? Right, and we got a payload. Right, so we need what? We need to answer a question here, and we need to call it here with value. I mean, I actually can just pass it over here, right? Because I don't care about that intermediate function. Cool, we got it prepared, so now we have to go and handle that answer a question thing. Now the question is, do we have actually, we have update question here. Okay, cool. So this is, I guess, expression date question user. Okay, owner can update question, so we need something different. We need answer method, which again I did not create it, because I basically forgot about that part. So we are gonna duplicate, I guess, this one. So answer JS. Copy the update thing, and question ID answer. So we're gonna, yeah, it's gonna be authenticated. What do you don't like here again? Is it too long? Okay. Let me think. Yeah, we can do it this way. Right. So we got a question. We get answer from body, and if answer is undefined or answer is empty, we're gonna say answer should not be empty. We don't care about the date. We get the question. If the question not found, we throw an error. Okay, we don't care about ownership check. We don't care about that. We don't care about, so we're gonna say question answers. What was the model again? So we got answers, yes. Push answer. We actually need to do it this way, text answer, and wait, did I define a model for it? Yeah, okay, and user is remind me, how do I get a user again? What was it? Reac user ID. There we go. That stuff, right? Append new answer. Okay, and we send back the updated question. Right, okay, cool. We don't care about moment.js here. And now we need a test. Create new question. And then we need to answer that question. Question ID answer. Answer existing question. Question. So what was it? We question, okay, app get question ID, right? Did I use it in this way here? Let me check quickly. Apt-get user, apt-get question ID, perfect. So we post to answer, and we send, answer, test, answer. So we make sure that the, I don't actually care about all this data, right? Because we're only checking answers, and we need to say t equal actual body answers length. So I'm interested in lengths. It should be equal one. Retrieve one answer, and answers zero. Is it text or what do we set here? No, that's not what I want. Yeah, text. This is actually text and model, or am I screwing it up? Yeah, it is answer here. Okay, so it should be answer. It should be aliased here, answer user. Good. So answer, it should be equal const answer. Let's put it into variable test answer. You know what, I don't think I use it anywhere else, so we're gonna just go with answer here. Answer and retrieve same answer, same, there we go. I don't need to set anything, and no, that's not npm test. Theoretically, that should work. Nope. Of course, I forgot to include it. Import answer from answer. And then we're going to do answer app, right? And this way it should work. Okay, and there are some problems. Okay, deep equal is obviously going to be broken. So, but actually the answering thing works fine. Cool. Retrieve same question. So the only problem now is that the other quests are okay, expected body, actual body. This is what question ID should not update question without text. No, this is not what is broken. Should update question. Okay, let's should get question back if same data is not sent. So this is the one that is broken. But I guess we can actually expected body, actual body. Expected body in this case, question. Okay, so we can just update the get question, right? So we can do that. And then it should be, it is a wrong terminal. And then this should be working fine. Am I correct? Yay, perfect. Add source and test. Okay, just to make sure. Okay, git commit, add way to answer questions. We did that. Whoops, that was the wrong button. NPM start. I think it actually wiped the database again because it uses it for testing, which is a bit unfortunate. So we're gonna have to clear the data here. And then, no, not test, come on. Yeah, okay, let's re-register again. Test. And in this case, all right, so we did that part. I need that right now. Okay, we need an answer, questions, world questions. Okay, so export const answer question. So we need to actually create a proper request, right? Action types answer question. Map, we need to sign request again, right? Switch map, header, and we need a payload in this case. So observable. Okay, I'm gonna do it this way. Ajax get, no, in this case it's gonna be post, right? So this is payload, and in this case we are actually, what headers, there we go, map res into res response, and map this is gonna be question. I don't think we actually need to store it. We can actually store it, right? So question, and we can say that type It's going to be action type. Come on, action types. We need actually to update answer question success, answer question error. Copy that stuff. So what we need to do now is answer question success and payload question. And then we need to catch thing and error it. We need to say observable of type. Come on, action types, answer question, no, not success, wait, answer question error, and payload error, right? So just to be consistent here, what is this unexpected token? Did I mess something up? We got switch map. This is my function. Okay, let me see, what did I screw up? So this now is fine, right? So, and if I paste this here, this is the, oh, I forgot to close the, wait, that should be here. There we go. Now that looks fine. Okay, and you want a trailing comma here. Right, so we, yeah, that's not equals, that should be our function. Now we have our answer question thing, which first of all we should plug in here, and answer question. And now we need to handle it in reducer, right? So this is all questions. Answer questions logic, let's annotate it a bit, all questions logic. So in this case is basically case action type answer question success. What we want to do is we want to take state questions and then find, so first of all let's let's actually extract the question from the payload, right? So we got question, should be action payload, right? Did I named it question? Okay, we don't need that anymore. Payload, no, okay, so it's just payload. It's this is our, let's call it updated question, right? So we take that. And then we return state. We find question so that question ID equals updated question ID. And I guess we're gonna find index, that would make more sense. Find index, const index. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna mutate the questions to updated question, right? And return state, which, yeah, it will probably say us do not reassign the stuff, this is a bad idea. Index, there we go. So we're gonna do that. What do you don't like? Trading spaces. Yes, okay, so what do you don't like? Lexical declarations in case block. Yeah, I mean, that kind of, you know, all of that stuff kind of makes sense, but let's see, we can do it this way. And then we can, how do you properly expect, I mean, nah, that's fine, that should be fine. I mean, let's do it this way, right? No, I don't think that actually solves it. Okay, and action payload, but action payload. Okay, so theoretically that should swap it. I mean, there are linting errors, but I will have to dig around how to actually, you know, correctly do this within Redux. What's the good way of doing that? But let's give it a shot. But I don't think I actually trigger it yet. So We are interested in homepage, and here, once I click answer question, okay, it triggers answer question. So let's say test. We get a network request. We don't do a network request. Why we don't do a network request? So this is our action. Oh yeah, because I don't actually, no, wait, I do handle it here, right? So case action types answer. Yeah, come on, what is wrong with you? Answer question, return state. Okay. Why doesn't do any requests? What am I missing here? Does it actually dispatches the, no, it doesn't. Okay, that is curious. Oh, no, wait, that's correct. An answer, okay, so that should bubble to the homepage where we should, right, okay, I mean, handle answer. Let's create another function and see what's wrong. Handle answer, value, and there we go, value, right? Just to make sure, answer value, and then theoretically that should actually dispatch. Okay, so this triggers it, but nothing happens. All right, so why the hell nothing happens? Answer question. Yeah, okay, answer question. Did I plug in the reducer? Yes, okay, I have it in questions, so it should be there. Answer question, I mean, it actually shouldn't be here because I don't care about it, right? So I only care about, and this can be case action types, answer question, whoops, error. So because errors are all the same, have the same structure, we can just do that. Right, so what's wrong? Why is it not answer question? Did I plug it in here? I did. Cool. Have this, which dispatches type answer question. And this off type answer question. Sign request. Switch map observable post. A P question. Okay. That's what the problem is. Like this is one. Problem number one. Let's go one by one. This should be payload question ID actually. So we actually need to send more stuff in the payload than I do now, right? Because right now the payload is only so question should be question and then should be answer. This should be the payload actually, right? Because let's do it this way, question answer, question answer, there we go. And this means we have to modify this one because it should be question here, answer should be text, there we go. Okay, so and then question ID and then answer and then here answer is payload answer. That's what we should be doing, right? Let's see, ASD. Okay, so we now correctly set the payloads. Yes, we got that part. Now why the hell does request not happens? Is that actually, yeah, that seems to be correct. Am I importing answer question from a wrong place here? Am I doing stupid things? No, that is correct as well. And this should actually trigger it. Oh, god damn it. I am doing stupid things. Dispatch is not defined. Oh, okay, right. Answer question. So, payload It should be dispatch answer question payload, right? I'm forgetting you have to dispatch those things as well. So, and then answer question. Let's just call it answer. And basically in this case, it should be answer and then the payload. And now that should work, right? So test answer. Ding. Answer is not a function. Wait. Dispatch to props. Yes. Am I shadowing it somewhere? Doesn't actually seem so. Oh, God, bloody I do. Okay, let's call it do answer. There we go. Now it should not be shadowed. Test answer and answer this. And let's have a look at the, yes. So now we actually have answers here. And in this case, if I reload, yeah, so we should see the empty thing. So what, like, okay. I think if I actually now replace this thing here, right, that should be working. Let's close that for now. What I need is I need a question component, and in question component I need to render those answers. So let's say, is there, let me have a look at the CSS, is there any good way to render something like lists, maybe in components, labels, navs, list groups. Yeah, that looks fine. Let's do a list group. So I'm gonna add a list group here, and then we are gonna take this like lead thingy and class name, and this is gonna have so I actually have to wait, question answers answers map, and then answer, and then there should be two, yep, and this should be answer text, right? And it should have key, so I'm gonna do answer index, and we're gonna just say that key is index, right? Why is it empty? Answer is it? Oh, answer, because it's answer actually, right? It's not text. Yeah, there we go. Cool. So that looks a bit weird. So maybe I will just, maybe it requires the UL tag. So I'm gonna do it this way, UL class name. Yeah, I guess it's gonna be better if I do it this way. And then I just align that stuff. Yes, like this. So basically, did I screw it up somewhere? Oh yeah, I forgot to close the UL. So then basically if we don't have it, it's just plain text. If we have answers, yeah, okay, now it looks actually nice. Okay, and another answer, the other question is, it should theoretically update dynamically, right? Because there we go, so now we have two answers. And Redux should have actually updated the answers. Come on, no, just god damn it, show me the answers one. Okay, this is state, this is what I want to see. Questions, answers, it now has two answers, but it doesn't trigger redraw for some reason. Is it, no, it's not, because I have, let me think. Why is it not triggering the redraw actually? questions because no, this is functional component. It should be redrawn on data change. Okay, I mean, this is again something that I will investigate in depth a bit more. But we have that. So we have question answering, we have rendering of multiple questions, and now we need the create new question thing. So I am gonna, let's actually commit this stuff that we did so far. I guess git status, let's see, git diff. So aside from the stuff, yeah, we did some Lodash stuff. Okay, cool. Git add, git commit, add way to browse and answer questions. That's what I'm gonna do. Cool, so now we need a new page, which should be pages create. Do index.js. We can just copy this stuff from home. I don't think I need any of those yet. So okay, let me just command that stuff. So we won't need question here. We won't need that stuff. So I'm just gonna leave it. I mean, okay, let's, you know what, let's command this. We don't need functions. I'm gonna just command this as well and create. You are not gonna have any props yet, so let's just do it this way. And then okay, so we have the create, which actually means that this should not be link, and actually here on the home page we can also remove the link from browse questions because we already here, right? It only makes sense. Okay, we got that, and let's do create question page just to make sure that it actually works. Create, there we go. And okay, I don't need Lodash here. And what I need is now to plug it into our router, right? So first of all, import create from pages create and root path create components create, and I think that should be it. So yeah, okay, that actually screws up the formatting of the thing quite marvelously, so I'm gonna do this. Let me copy this. Well, you don't like here a must not point to well, too bad for you thing, but I mean, can I just do this? Will that be sufficient? Yeah, okay, that works. So I can just wrap it in A and then bootstrap formats them correctly, because otherwise it looks ugly as hell. Let's just do this. Cool. All right, so now we actually have create, and maybe a good idea to somehow to do it maybe this way. I mean, basically, you know, somehow highlight that we are actually on this page. So, come on, there we go. Yeah, that looks much better. Okay, create question page. Let's see, what do we actually do when we create question? Post create new question with different user, and here's our input text, expiration date, and that's basically it. Okay, so that should be straightforward. I don't need that anymore. Let's first build that form. Pam pam pam, we don't need that. So we need text and expiration date, and that's about it, right? So it's very, very straightforward thing. Let's go to forms again and copy paste a nicely formatted form. Like, we don't need all of those inputs, but whatever. Okay, first of all, we need text and we need expiration date. We don't need anything else for now. Create new question, let's call it this way. And now I need to replace all this class with class name. So this is gonna be question text, come on, text, question text, and we're going to use the input here because we want to encourage user to write short questions. So that, you know, I mean, you can use text area, obviously, but then it usually assumes a lot of text and we want to keep it brief. Then it's not going to be a password, it's going to be expiration date. And what you are going to be text as well. And going to be expiration date. Is there actually a type field data? Okay, so now that this is another thing I want to change. Input type date. I know that there is, I think, on mobile basically, but does it actually work on desktop? What's the support of that thing? I'm sure browser. That that's very helpful. Can I use? That's my can I use thing. Input type date. Date and time, okay. Firefox doesn't support it? That is really. No, date time, okay. What about just date? Okay, that is very interesting, but let's give it a shot. I mean, in the end, I think we will have to replace it with okay, so here you can actually have a nice collab. That's actually very nice. And I think if it's gonna be date time, which is the one that having problems with support, basically. No, okay, so this doesn't seem to support it as well. I mean, I think we're just gonna use the component in the end, but let's just do the this one for now. So what do we need to do? We need to say let question text, and then let question date, and then we need to assign references to them, right? So let me do it in this way. Not like the god damn it, come on, this is what I want to do. Yes, format that a bit, and then ref. So this is gonna be text and say question text T. Okay, you want brackets here, right? Yeah, there we go. And then I'm gonna do the same here. There we go, ref D, and that's gonna be question date. So now we have both of those and create a question. So we're gonna do on click handler, handle create, which is gonna be over here, const handle create. We don't care about, no, we care about event, right? So we wanna do prevent default. And then return false. And in this case, let's just do console log question text value and question date value. So let's give it a shot. Create a question. Okay, so we got the new date and we got the new text. Like one thing is probably, since I'm using the moment.js on the server side to parse the dates, it would be a good idea to use it on the client side as well, you know, for sort of consistency at least. And I mean, moment is in general a really great library for working with dates. It makes it a lot easier. Moment from moment, and then so let's do date, moment, question date value. So let's do it this way. Yep. I probably, it's a good idea to restart it. Come on. Loading. Okay, now it seems to be working, and let's check that this stuff is actually works fine. There we go. And we have a moment thing. Let me just make a short break here. Gonna be back in a second. All right, I am back. Let's continue with that. So we got the moment, and I think we need moment.js. Moment has a function to transform date to the So let's first look how we actually to date. Okay, so I just do the to date. So we're gonna do exactly the same here, which means select this stuff, create. Cool. So we got the data. And const text. Okay, what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna copy this structure and just use exactly that. Input text and then kill that, right? Because we're entering text and expiration date because we're entering them. All right, and now we need to actually send that to the server, right? So post, there we go. So what do we need? We need first to create an action, which would be new question, right? Create question. And for that case, we need again three more constants. I need to select all of them. Create question, and we now have three new things that we can work with. So create question, right? And we're just gonna go and give the payload whatever is passed here. So that's the first thing we have to do, create question. I'm gonna do create question from actions, right? And create questions. Let's call it do create question. I mean, it might be a better idea to import this with a different name and then just use them here because it's the only place where they are used. But okay, let's just go with this one for now. And this is what I want to do, right? So I mean, we don't really need this input here, so we can just trigger it this way, which means this is going to be the payload. And this looks good. So we trigger it, and now we need handlers. So we need epic and we need registering. So in this case, we can copy answer because we're doing the post request, right? So it's going to be create question, right? And we're just going to post to this one. And then the payload is going to be just passed over here. Headers is the same. Okay, we don't need this single quotes. We just need that part. And in this case, create question. Come on, create question success. And create question error. Looks good. There's actually a lot of copy pasting here. Maybe I should just abstract this method into, basically because the only thing we change here is this URI payload and headers are also the same because we signed the request with whatever is our token, right? So it's a bit of quite a lot of boilerplate, let's put it this way. Okay, so case, let's add create question error handling right away because it's the same. And we actually have to do something about the errors because I don't actually render it right now, right? So it's just silently fails basically. Create question success, return state. But what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say state questions push action payload, because I think it actually returns, that is a wrong button. Let me see. So when we post, yeah, it actually returns the question in the body, so we can just push the payload in the state, and that should update the state, and then we can just redraw or change the URI, I guess, to our. We actually shouldn't even need to do that, but okay, let's see. Let me think. So we did that. Theoretically, that should be sufficient, right? Let's test. New question. Put this whatever date, create question, and nothing happens. Why does nothing happen? Oh yeah, because I forgot to include that part in here. Right. Okay, there we go. New question, question mark. Let's make it a question. that is an old date. Let's make it this way. Bad request. All right, well, at least it sends a request. That's a good sign. Date should be valid iso date. Okay, I guess toDate is not the correct function. Let's have a look at the moment.js API. Docs. Dot to string format to iso string. I guess this is what we want, right? Where was here we go? Wait, but here I am doing it today date. Oh yeah, because but wait, this way it sends. I guess the super agent does encoding on its own. Okay, so we are gonna have to properly encode it ourselves. Okay. New question, question mark, and 27, create. Network, let's see. Okay, we got it created. Let's check the Redux question success. Let's see the state. And we actually have it in the state, which is good. So basically, if I now switch to browse questions here, I should see it. Perfect. I guess this should happen automatically. And to do that, what I want is question success. So I guess this is gonna be, let's do it this way. So it's gonna be expand state, and then like for now, I'm just gonna say nav to root, which basically would mean okay, you know what, let's give that plugin a shot, because I am a bit tired of figuring out of all the workarounds that we can do to actually navigate from one page to another correctly. There's this Redux history transitions thing, so okay, but let's you know what, let's first actually commit what we have, because we know that it works. Git status, okay, git add, make sure that we have added all that we actually want to add. Looks good. Git commit, add question, let's call it basic question creation, right? And now let's go ahead and try to add this Redux history transition, yarn add Redux history transition. And I think after we added that and it works, this is gonna be the last thing we're gonna do today. So we're gonna wrap it up. The passing enhancer requires Redux 3.1. I think we have actually the later Redux. Which one do we have? We have 3.6. Okay, so that looks good. Handle transition. So this means we have to tinker with our store, which means we import it here. And create store reducer initial state enhancer. That's not how create store signature looks, isn't it? Redux.js. Okay, what was it? Redux.js.org, I think, is the docs, right? Yeah, there we go. API reference, create store, there we go, reducer. Okay, so it is an enhancer, and enhancer. There we go. Okay, so that theoretically should work. Middleware. Create new history. Come on, history enhancer. And browser history. I think we don't really, yeah, so enhancer. Right, so we did that part. Let's check that it actually works. Right, npm start. Okay, come on. Da, 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 da. Come on, build it. There we go. All right, so far so good. So it didn't break anything. That's always a good sign. Okay, now when we want to do a transition, we want to add this meta thing, right? So let's, for example, let's wipe my authentication right now and go ahead and add it to login. So right now in login, I do this set immediate thing, which is a stupid way of doing it. So I'm going to kill it, and I'm going to kill that nav to home here. Token is something I don't care about anymore as well, right? Push, I don't care about as well. Okay. Good, so we cleaned it. So basically, even if I log in now, it won't redirect me anywhere. But right now in Reducer, when we say logged in, we should be able to say meta and add this transition thing, which in this case, I don't actually care. So we just want to redirect to the root, right? And that's actually all I want, I think. Let me just make sure. Nav to home, and yeah, we just redirect to the root. Okay, maybe I should have opened another window so that we don't wait for the completion again. But let's see. So if that works, that is actually a really cool approach and way more consistent and reliable than what I did before. And that doesn't seem to be working, which is a bit annoying. Okay, meta is empty. Why is it empty? Okay then. Am I doing it incorrect? This is, now you can dispatch actions in the following type logged in payload meta. Yes, that's, oh, that should be an action. Okay, so it should not be in a state. Right, that is me doing stupid stuff. So we need to dispatch an action that it says logged in, which means that we have to change our epic, right? So this is where it says login successful, and we add this meta thing. Okay, let me wipe my thing here. Then we're gonna do test. And what? Login success, payload. Yes, so why the, what? Why the hell it doesn't work? Meta transition, yeah, return a new object that says path name root. Man, that looks fine to me. Why are you not working? Is it because it tapped in the wrong history? Is that why? Because I remember we bootstrapped the history, so we have the history thing here. That is, I wonder if it wants this one. If it does, this is a bit of a bonkers. Create an enhanced history. Okay, let's have a look here. You have to create your history instance here and pass it to the store enhancer in order to use search. You have to enhance your user queries enhancer. Okay. Right. So why you don't. Let me think. Meta transition. So in theory, I mean, does it actually action? Yeah, it does have meta, right? So this looks fine. And I assume it has the function there. It just doesn't show it here because it's actually proper function. So why are you not working? Okay, we don't need that anymore. We don't need that right now. We don't care about that right now. Okay, this is the one part we care about, and this is the other part we care about. Meta transition, yes. Oh, wait a second. What? Now you can dispatch action in the following form. You have desired transition automatically executed for you. Uh-huh. Register user and while above works, it can quickly become tedious if you always have to manually check whether an action was completed successfully or failed. Now, I mean, I'm fine with checking, but that just doesn't work for me. I'm guessing it taps in the wrong history, right? So what we can do is, so what if I kill this history over here and then I say export default, we export a function that takes in a history and does all of that stuff and returns a store. And in this case, we will have to say history here. Okay, and that means here we need store, right? So, oh, but you need a, no, okay, so that can be true because you need a store to synchronize that history. So that's not how it works. Mm-hmm. So why the hell it doesn't work? Okay, there is an example. Let's have a look at that. And there are some issues here. How to navigate backwards. That is not my problem. Reducers, roots, index.js, create store history. So where does it history comes from? Use queries. Use queries. Okay, so this is actually browser history. What is this use queries from here? So do I need to use it, I guess, right? Why is this history JS? Come on. Okay, so what is this use queries? Is it mentioned somewhere? Okay, note, in order to use search, you have to enhance your history. Okay, I don't want to use search. I don't care about search. In this case, at least, path name. Maybe I have to provide state as well. Is that a must there? Transition, path name. You just state. Is that what you want? Test, test. No, but it is success, and it does dispatches action, all of that stuff. Okay, so that just, okay, I mean, that stuff doesn't work, so this is like one of the parts that I will have to figure out on my own, I guess, because it probably will take quite some time to do that, so I'm gonna just kill all of that for now and see why it doesn't work later on. Okay. Did I code actually anything worthy? No. Git or ha, reset all that stuff. And yeah, I think that's about it. So we actually did most of the question creation and fetching and answering related things. So what do we have? We have user profiles that are left. We have let's have a look here. I mean, you know what, we can just actually go to the server and do npm test here, and we will see all the methods that we need to implement, right? That's all the beauty of good test suite. So let's see, we got registration, we got authentication ready, we missing user profiles for now, we got question creation, we got question answering, we got Okay, we don't have question updates. That's one thing. And that's basically it. So user profiles and question editing, I guess. And question closing, but this is more of a server logic that we can implement later on. So I guess we can wrap it up here. I won't push the code just yet because there is this, shouldn't be issues actually. There's a pull request from, again, the same guy, Javier, that is pending now. There are some minor changes. I want him to make this stuff before I merge it, but as I said, it fixes the notification issues, which should be a nice addition. And once this is merged, I will push, rebase my code and push the all the changes, which hopefully will be within the next few days. But yeah, you know, so far so good. I think we would need like one more maybe live stream to finish this all, and then we can come to the like complete deployment of the whole thing and maybe continuous integration, continuous delivery with GitLab CI for client side. So we have a nice artifact that we can just publish. But yeah, that's about it. So thank you for watching. Thank you for staying with me. And, you know, as always, see you next time. Bye, guys.